Agenda 2030, people. Hey guys, Robert J. Morris here, and it's Wednesday, April 13th, 2016. In this article I found today in the Washington Post, they talk about 250 million, 300 scientists and 40 labs, Sean Parker's revolutionary project to solve cancer. Well, San Francisco. Billionaire Sean Parker, famous for his founding roles at Napster and Facebook, is backing an unconventional $250 million effort to attack cancer that involves persuading hundreds of the country's top scientists, who are often in competition with each other, to join forces and unify their research targets. The consortium, which will be formally announced Wednesday, focuses on immunotherapy. I'm not sure if that's today Wednesday or next Wednesday. They aren't clear unless they give a date later. Focuses on immunotherapy, a relatively new area of research that seeks to mobilize the body's own defense systems to fight mutant cancer cells. Many believe it represents the future of cancer therapy. More than 300 scientists working at 40 labs and 6 institutions, Stanford, the University of California, have already signed on. Cancer immunotherapy is an incredibly complex field, and for every answer, it seems to pose 10 more questions. I'm an entrepreneur, so I wish some of these questions had been answered yesterday. A centralized scientific steering committee comprised of one member from each participating university will set the group's research agenda and coordinate data collection and clinical trials across the many sites. Look at this. There's an article. Tech whiz Sean Parker's $24 million bet on an allergy cure. He goes on about how this allows us to run a much more competitive negotiation with industry. We would become a kind of one-stop shop for the technology. If you go down here, there's a video.
Your body's own immune cells are some of the greatest weapons you have against cancer.
I'm just going to stop it right there, because what does that sound like? Basically, what they're doing is they're going to effectively embrace holistic style remedies and bring them out into the pharmaceutical industry. And how are they going to do this? Well, we collectively found out about the TPP several months ago, and how they were going to have special exclusivity on biologics. Well, let's go back over here and I'll remind you guys what that's about. And it talks about a biological product. There's a footnote one here. And below that it says, in the U.S., a biological product is defined in the Public Health Service Act as a virus, therapeutic serum, toxin, antitoxin, vaccine, blood component or derivative, allergenic product, protein, except any chemically synthesized polypeptide. Protein is important, which I'll get to in a moment, or analogous product, or arsphenamine, or derivative of arsphenamine, or any other trivalent organic arsenic compound applicable to the prevention, treatment, or cure of a disease or condition of human beings. And also in the TPP under biologics, it goes basically into more detail, like for the purposes of this section, each party shall apply this article to, at a minimum, a product that is or alternatively contains a protein produced using biotechnology processes for use in human beings for the prevention, treatment, or cure of a disease or condition. Now, this is important because going back to this other article here, we find out about Carl June here. Other scientists involved, including immunotherapy pioneers Carl June at the University of Pennsylvania and James Allison at MD Anderson, who was awarded the prestigious Lasker Prize in 2015 for his discovery of a drug that uses the body's T cells to destroy cancer. That is also known as CD19 targeted chimeric antigen receptor, and it's a T cell therapy for acute lymphoblastic leukemia. However, one of the things that he ran into was cytokine release syndrome, posing a unique challenge for toxicity management. And that's very much related to the cancer die-off and ammonia poisoning. Just look that up. That's beyond the scope of this video because we're just looking at some of the players that are involved in this pharmaceutical, I guess you could say, rally. And we'll call it a rally, and you'll see why shortly. Might it be known, since we're talking about proteins and his dealings with T-cells, T-cells are activated by an activation factor. Does that sound familiar? And we're talking about protein derivatives. I very much would like to entertain the fact that I think they're talking about GC-MAP. They won't say it because that will lend credence to the holistic community. They have ways around that by using tricky language. However, if you look at the function of what's happening in these pharmaceutical protocols, then believe me, it will start to make sense what is happening. Yes, even the Gates Foundation wants a piece of the pie. Well, the Gates Foundation has received much praise for saving lives through its work. Philanthropy on this scale isn't without critics. Oh, wow, that is rich. Researchers worry about the pitfalls of groupthink, and several years ago, the World Health Organization's head of malaria research accused the foundation of being a cartel that suppressed the diversity of scientific opinion. Oh, yeah. Awesome. Well, let's see what they're working on here. Here's a little write-up on Bill Gates. What is he doing? Oh, he's betting on a new company that just raised $100 million to create a simple blood test for every form of cancer. Yes, this is where they're going with this. Oh, what is it called? Illumina. Right. Can't be any more obvious right there, guys. The $25 billion maker of gene sequencing technology has created a new company that's trying to invent a blood test to identify all cancers in their early stages, something that would be a tremendous help in diagnosing the illness before it is too difficult to treat effectively. Okay, so the team behind the announcement is not the first to attempt something of this nature, and previous efforts by other companies have been criticized for having too little research behind them or focusing too much on detection rather than treatment. Crucially, this blood test does not exist yet, and while scientists will be working furiously to try to make it happen, it doesn't mean they will succeed. The new company? Called Grail. Wow. I wonder if there's a third reference in here. It'd be a hat trick. As in, it's trying to achieve something considered the holy grail for cancer researchers. Like, I mean, unbelievable. That would mean that anyone could add such a test into their annual physical. No need to separate tests for different types of lung cancer, prostate cancer, or any other form of illness. This is interesting and also arguable, so don't fight me too hard on this. But here's a good one. The key to this effort is the ability to detect what's known as circulating tumor DNA. Or ctDNA. In recent years, doctors have discovered that the genetic material from cancerous tumors starts circulating in our bodies. Yeah, because you poke frickin' holes in them when you do biopsies, dumbasses. Of course they're going to be sending cells everywhere. That's how you're spreading it. You don't, when your body's trying to compartmentalize a disease, you don't go poking holes in the thing. Anyway, so that's a whole nother argument for another day. And moving along, I'm only scratching the very surface of this right now, but I want to keep the video short. So anyway, so as you can see, I'm not saying that the warnings went unheeded. I'm saying that when we figured this out last year, at the end of last year with the TPP coming out, we all knew that there was going to be something happening. Well, we felt that. And now we've seen it unfold, because what they're literally doing is, if you ask me, this is strictly opinion, and I will be bringing up the question of the dead holistic doctors. And my hearts go out to all the families, friends, patients, and just the people that they inspired. My hearts go out to all of you, because this is very, very, very sick. But when I've heard news out there where there's like, you know, rumors going around that maybe the holistic doctors had a plan that they were going to bring to light, and that's why they're being knocked off or whatever. Look, in my opinion, I don't think they had a plan because, unfortunately, and I don't mean to cause any offense when I say this, but we can't even get the whole holistic community together to support each other publicly because a lot of people are afraid. So I don't buy that. And if there's a plan, I think it's these guys opening up open season on holistics so that they can take the lead and basically make a profit from what holistic practitioners and teachers alike have been trying to bring to the public. So listen, this is an appeal to everybody out there who is either a researcher, a holistic practitioner, or any form of a follower of the truth here. I think it's our due diligence and our duty to start teaching others. I mean, we can't hide. We got to stick together and teach as many. I mean, we can learn faster than they can knock us off. Believe me, we have a duty to spread this knowledge everywhere. And when people see that it works and it doesn't have to come from Big Pharma, I think that'll start to get people to see what the intentions are with mainstream medicine. Anyway, start making more videos. Start teaching each other through other social medias. I mean, if YouTube or Facebook isn't your thing, then there's Zeekly.com. There's Vimeo. There's Tumblr. There's all kinds of different social media platforms that we can use to get to other people and teach. It's important now. It's more important now than ever because before we know it, damn it. I just don't like where this is headed. Excuse me if you think this is fear porn, but this is reality. They're setting us up and their agenda is being carried out. That's all I have to say about that, guys. And let's take care of each other. Peace out.